Good morning, students. Welcome to the class. In the previous class, we have completed reflection and searing. Okay. So today we have discussed composite 3D transformation. Okay. And modeling the 3D transformation. How to model it and composite the 3D transformation. Okay, all these things we have covered. The composite 2D transformation also we have covered. How the transformation can be, more than one transformation can combine and one task is performed. That means first we translate it, then we scale it, then again we translate it. All these things were different types of transformation method we can combine in a single task. Okay. So, how it can possible in 3D geometry, let us discuss. So, composite 3D transformation. Let us take one example, then we will discuss it. So, in this example, it will transform a line segment P1, P2 and P1, P3 from their start position in to their ending position. Okay. So, here in this figure, P1, P2. P1, P2 means this line. This line and P1, P3 means this line. These two lines can be, this one is our starting and ending position is our this figure. That means these things will be transformed from this position. That means this one is our original position or source position, source place, and this our destination place. So, how it can possible? Okay. The first solution is to compose the primitive transformation. Is first translate it, then rotate it, then again we translate it. That means transformation is T, then R, X, X, R, Y, R, J. Okay. All these things we translate it. But that means rotation in x axis, rotation in y axis, rotation in z axis. Okay. This approach is easier to illustrate and does offer help on building and understanding. The second more abstract approach is to use the properties of spatial orthogonal matrices. So, let us forget these things. Only we will how to translate it, how to rotate it, all these things we will discuss here. So, here this one is our question. Now we can solve it. So, the composition of 3D in the 3D transformation, breaking the problem into simpler sub problems. That means, first we translate the P1 to the origin. That means, here P1 point. The P1 point is here. First, we translate the P1 point to the origin. Origin point is this one. Okay. This center point. So, this P1 point is translate to the center point. So, in the second figure, the P1 point is the origin position. Okay. Next, we rotate about the y axis such as P1, P2 lies in the yz plane. So, then in the third position in this diagram, we rotate the P1, P2. P1, P2 means this line will be rotate here and this line will lie in xy plane. Now, we rotate it and this line will be lie in the yz plane. Okay. Or y axis, then this one is your third step. again we this one is our second step. Then we in the third step we rotate about the x axis such that p1 p2 lies in the z axis. Then p1 p2 lies in the z axis. That means this one is rotated in the yz plane, but here in the z axis p1 p2 lying in the z axis, on the z axis line, over the z axis line. In the next step again we rotate about the z axis such that p1 p3 lies in the yz plane. Then again in the last step we rotate the p1 p3. Here we one rotate only p1 p2. Then we rotate the p1 p3 line, which line lies on in the yz plane or z axis plane. Yz, this one is our z axis. So in this way the figure is, original figure is here, but when we rotate these three steps the next position is like this. Okay, our question is that this one is our question and output is our this one. So in this way we can rotate it. Okay, in the diagrammatically this one is here. Now in the equation form or in the matrix form, how it can be solved? First we translate it, that means translate in reverse form. That means minus x1 minus y1 minus z1, translate in reverse form. That means the matrix form is this one: 1 0 0 0 minus x1, 0 1 0 minus y1, 0 0 1 minus z1, 0 0 0 1. This matrix form is right in the equation form. Okay, p1 dash equals to t into minus x1 minus y1 minus z1 into p1 equals to 0 0 0 1 to the power square. Okay, then p1 dash p3 dash, all these things we will write in the same manner. Okay, now second step is our rotation. Rotation in the y axis. Okay, here we also write here rotation in the y axis. That means yz plane, p1 p line only, rotation in the yz plane. So when we rotation in the yz plane or y axis, it will rotation y in minus 90 degree minus theta. Okay, so the equation, the matrix form is this one. Okay, now matrix form is sin theta 0 minus cos theta 0, 0 1 0 0 cos theta 0 sin theta 0 sin theta 0 0 0 0 1. Then next in third step we rotate it in the z axis. Okay, here we also write na, rotate it p1 p2 line in the z axis. In the z axis, rotation in z axis, that means the line lies in the z axis line, p1 p2 line. Okay, in this way the matrix form is 1 0 0 0 0 cos theta minus sin theta 0, 0 sin theta cos theta 0, 0 0 0 1. Then last one is the p1 p3 line in the, also lies in the z axis. That means finally we composite the matrix equation is rotation in z axis, rotation in x axis, rotation in y axis into transformation in reverse form. That means r into t, that means rotation into translation. All these things when we complete this, finally we got that things. Okay, and the composite matrix is also in this way. Okay, so this one is our composite 3D transformation. How we rotate, how more than one transformation method can use in an object when we when the object is transformation. Okay, next we have discussed modeling and coordinate transformation. Okay, in the 3D transformation there, here only 3 axis. But in 2D, there are two axes, x axis and y axis. But in 3D, x axis, y axis and z axis. The x axis rotation is called pitch, y axis rotation is called yaw, and z axis rotation is called roll. Okay. In the above figure, it shows 3 axis and the sign convention used for both translation and rotation. These axes in VRUT are left handed. This one is our left handed thumb. Okay. As a mnemonic, hold your left hand so that your thumb points to the right, your index finger points straight up, and your middle finger points directly away from you. Middle finger directly away from you. Remember these things. Your finger are now indicating the positive x, y and z direction respectively. These things and this diagrammatic we will discuss in first class of the 3D geometric transformation. The left finger will shows how and the right finger will shows how. And the each and every fingers will shows in which direction. Okay. The rotation about these three same axes are referred to as yaw, pitch and roll. Okay. The left hand rule is used for the sign convention when rotating about these three axes. The mnemonic for this is to point your left thumb along the positive axis you want to rotate, you which axis you want to rotate. Okay. The rest your fingers are now pointing the direction of positive rotation around that axis. Okay. So in this way we can convert or we can point out the how the object is modeling and how the coordinate positions are, coordinate transformations are shows like. Okay. So in today's class we will cover 3D composite 3D transformation and modeling and coordinate transformation. Okay. So the unit 7 will be completed.